Get ready to match the stars. Scully Mitchell, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Sharon Farrell, Richard Dawson, and Mary Wicks as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. Here's the star of Match Game 78, Gene Ryder.
Thank you, Mario. Thank you, friend. I greet you one and all.
Isn't it terrible about Scully's disease? Those black spots all over him.
It's not a spot, Jim.
Oh, I see. Oh, you get little holes in the shirt. Yeah.
Listen, you know, we've started with... Oh, it's not there yet. Well, I'll tell you about our new star wheel a little bit later, because we're going to start the show that way with Jim Smadak, who won the game. He's going to have a shot at the real big money. Maybe $10,000 with just one spin of the wheel. You ready for that, Jim?
I'm all ready.
Okay, we'll do it right after this.
Buzzer presents
one, or go to seniorsunited.com.
Seniors United Insurance.
Here we are, Jim Smadak and Gene Rayburn standing in front of this big star wheel. Now, Jim, with the aid of this wheel, you can win as much as $10,000 with just one spin of that wheel in one match. But to begin with, we're going to do the regular audience match, and here we go. We polled the studio audience not too long ago, and we said, you write down your best answer to this, rotten blank. If you match the answer they wrote down most often, you get $500. For matching their second most popular answer, $250, and then for matching the third, $100. Three of our six celebrities will give you a little help here.
Sure.
Rotten egg.
Yeah! Rotten egg. Answer number one.
Scully.
Scully.
Rotten rat.
Rotten rat. Couldn't think of anything, could you, Scully?
Can I try
right, one more? Richard.
Oh, thanks.
Present.
Yeah, present.
Wait a minute, something may come from...
Wait a minute, you might get an idea.
No, wait a minute.
He can do it.
What they used to throw at me when I did my... Oh, you're very
nice. No, here it is, kid.
Wait a minute. He's still thinking. Now, give
me... They used to throw...
Away a very good answer. I'd look, I'd cool this before.
Second. Well, in that case, I hope you won't take this the wrong way. You're rotten to the core.
Rotten to the core.
Thank you, Tom.
Rotten to the core. That was a great Beelily line. Maud, you're like rotten to the core. Remember that?
Yeah.
Anyway, rotten to the core is one, rotten rat, and rotten egg. Now, you have an option here of choosing one of those or thinking up one of your own.
I'll go with rotten eggs.
Yeah! Rotten eggs. That was Sharon's answer. Well, let's find out if we got any rotten eggs up there. May we see the $100 response. Rotten kids.
Oh, I got a couple of those.
Kids. What's the matter with kids today?
Rotten.
Okay. May we see the $250 number? Rotten apples.
Oh,
that didn't come up at all, did it?
They're rotten
okay.
to the core.
Yeah, the apples are rotten to the core there. Last chance for rotten to the core. Slide it if you please. Hey. In addition to all that, you win. In addition to that, you get $500. But that means the least you'll be playing for is 10 times that amount, or $5,000. But you can double the $5,000 if you have a lucky spin on our new star wheel. Let's go up here and have a look at it.
Double up, baby. Double up.
See, all of our celebrities' names are on there. And you're going to spin that wheel to find out which celebrity you'll be playing with. Now, if it happens to stop in this gold star area under any celebrity's name, such as that, you see the double sign lights up, and you'll be playing for double the $5,000 or $10,000. Now, the wheel must make at least one complete revolution. So grab a hold of Brett by the blank here, and give it a spin, and make it go past that mark.
Oh,
he's powerful. Isn't he powerful? Stop and hold. All right. play for $5,000 with Richard Dawson, and good luck to you. $5,000 ain't bad, Jim. Here it is. Here it is. You've got to match Richard. Blank Comics. Blank Comics.
C-O-M-I-C-S, right?
That's what I said, C-O-M-I-C-S. Everybody understand that? Okay, here we go. Good luck to you, Jim. Blank Comics. Give the answer matches Richard. We give you $5,000.
Stand-up comics.
Stand-up comics. Well, that's kind of a hip-in answer. Richard?
I didn't think he'd say. I said newspaper.
Newspaper comics. Yeah. All right. So listen, Jim, you've picked up a little more money here. You have a total of $1,200, and that's not bad. Now you're going to meet another player. Here comes Kathy Tripp. Let's welcome her. You brought the whole neighborhood with you, didn't you?
Not really. I'm from Alabama, and I just brought my mother.
Well, she's pretty noisy. I like the way she whistles and screams and hollers.
That's my mother did.
Oh. What do you do, if anything, Kathy?
Well, I'm a housewife. I'm married to a wonderful man, Ricky.
Yeah.
We have a six-month-old daughter, Jennifer. I'm a college graduate in education. And I like to cook, and I do needlepoint.
You do?
Yes, I do.
All of us girls do.
Yeah. No, let me see. That's about it.
Okay, good luck to you, Kathy.
Thank you.
James?
He's had a lot of good luck, yes?
Have you ever had a wife on here that was married to a rotten man?
Not one who's ever admitted it.
Yeah, they're all married to...
No, they're all married to wonderful fellas here.
Wonderful.
But before we start this game, first, this message. Never seen a guy. Oh, hello there.
You ought to...
Well... We're just having a little lecture here in physical education. Healthy people and all that sort of thing there. Oh, we've got that. And now, Kathy, you have a choice to make here of A or B.
I'll take A for Alabama.
A for Alabama.
That's where Fanny comes from.
Alabama. Mike said, I went to the world's chintziest bank. Instead of a vault, they put your money in a blank. Instead of a vault. It's a money in a blank. Kathy Krebs, are you ready?
Good, I'm glad they smell.
Mike said, I went to the world's chintziest bank. Instead of a vault, they put your money in a blank.
Right.
A lead box.
A what?
A leaded box.
A leaded box.
I can't believe it.
My dear, a leaded box is a coffin. Don't y'all know that? Alabama. Hello, Scoey. Hello, checking 1-2 testing.
We were just talking about that the other day, my wife and I. Cigar box. Remember them old cigar boxes?
Oh, yeah. Save your money in a cigar box. Yeah.
Remember?
Right. I remember. They don't remember, apparently. Yes?
You said a leaded box was a cigar, was a coffin?
Yes.
Certain. That I'd like to see you go into a leaded box. Okay. I said shoebox.
Shoebox. That's the way. No, shoebox is good. Nothing to be sorry about that at all. Chuck?
Hole in the wall.
Hole in the wall. That's a chintzy bank, all right. I must say that. A bank so chintzy, they put your money in a hole in the wall. Now, she said leaded box. What do you say?
Well, I hide things whenever I go. Things I don't want anybody to find in a sock. And
in
I
a
hold
sock.
It all up.
Right. And you roll it all up and put it in.
Nobody ever finds anything either, though.
Yes. Well, do you have many valuables?
Well, it's not really valuables. It's like things that you don't want to be found.
Oh, I see. All right.
Little extra.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, right.
Old scripts.
Okay. The chintziest bank in the world. Instead of a vault, they put money, your money in a...
Plastic baggie.
Plastic baggie. And they do the little ties and twist them ties.
Well, that is one chintzy bank, isn't it?
Yeah, that is very chintzy. But you can see through, you see, and know how much money you've got. You don't have to take it out and count it. What do you got,
Mine's
Mary?
Mine's pretty safe. It's a cigar box.
Cigar box is the, would seem to be the traditional answer. I don't know, but it's such a few. Jim, you ready?
Ready.
Here we go. Fred said, I knew R2-D2 when he was a baby. Then, he was just a little blank. R2-D2 when he was a baby. Then he was just a little blank.
I haven't seen Star Wars.
Okay, Jim. Fred said, you know who R2-D2 was? Yeah.
For sure.
Yeah.
I've seen
Fred
Star
said,
Wars.
I knew R2-D2 when he was a baby. Then he was just a little
toy.
Toy. You're so cute when you say those rotten answers. He's lovable.
I know.
He has a wonderful smile
he is.
And
He's
comes out
cute.
With those terrible answers and smiles and such confidence. Yeah. What do you say?
I say, let's get rid of him.
No, he's a champ. You can't
he's
get rid of him.
He's a bad seed.
I said he was just a little can opener.
Electric can opener. R2-D2 started out as a can opener. What do you say?
I say I think you're going to be sorry you ever asked this question. We don't seem to be coming. I said robot.
A little robot. Well, I suppose there are large robots and big ones, Charles.
Sure.
A little fuse.
Fuse is good. Yeah.
That's sweet.
Little fuse there. Sharon, what came to your little mind? A little coat hanger. That's cute.
Wasn't right, though.
No.
He's laughing at us.
You leave him
R.D. was his name?
R2-D2 when he was a baby. Then he was
a lot of people don't know that he had a sex change.
Oh, did he really?
I knew him when he was a transistor.
A transistor. Aha. Uh-huh. He had the operation. And it was done by a mechanic from RCA Institute. Yes, Mary.
Now, he was R2-D2 when he's grown up, right?
Right.
Knew him when he was R and a half, D and a half.
R and a half, D and a half. Very good.
That's a small one, right?
Right. Mine was little r, you know? Lowercase r, but you wouldn't understand. Okay.
That's why we don't ask you, Gene.
I'm glad I didn't say it. I was almost going to say that, but I didn't. Kathy, do you want A or B?
I'll take A again.
Hey, Gene.
What?
Why don't we just go straight to the tiebreaker?
No. No, somebody's going to score here.
Let's get the wheel down, Gene.
Right. We'll get the wheel down.
Colonel Sanders?
Colonel Sanders said, I'll be at my fried chicken restaurant tonight. For everyone who buys a bucket, I'll autograph one of their blanks. Colonel Sanders said that. I'll be at my fried chicken restaurant tonight, and for everyone who buys a bucket, I'll autograph one of their blanks. Jim Smadak. Colonel Sanders said, I'll be at my fried chicken restaurant tonight, and for everyone... What's that? Oh, it's Kathy. Oh, I beg your pardon. That's it.
He has these little lapses. It's premature senility.
I took a nap. I was walking over. I fell sound asleep there. Colonel Sanders said, I'll be at my fried chicken restaurant tonight. For everyone who buys a bucket, I'll autograph one of their blanks.
Chicken legs.
Chicken legs. Okay. I think you'll find the celebrities' answers may be a little more daring than that, Kathy. Scully?
Breastuses.
Breast. Okay. All right.
Mercy.
What do you say?
I say leg, I guess.
Legs. One for Kathy. Charles? Legs.
He's very daring. Don't say they're not going to be daring. That was a lovely, daring answer. Yeah. And here's another daring answer.
Okay, that's two for Kathy. Yeah, for everyone who buys a bucket, I'll autograph one of their...
Thighs.
All right.
That's a leg.
Well, it's the upper part.
Start me.
It's upper, but it's not the entire leg. Oh. Let's see.
Well, I said breath.
Breath. Okay.
And I'm glad I said it.
I'm glad you said it, too.
Well, thank you.
What does Mary say?
Well, it'd be hard to write on all that crisp stuff. I said it. Biscuits.
Biscuits. Autograph one of their biscuits, eh? Oh, dear. Okay. Well, you picked up two. That ain't bad. 2-0 score at this moment. Now we've got this for you.
Dumb Dora and Old Man Periwinkle.
Your screen, or visit us online today.
Today's consolation prize is our first La Machine by Moulinex, the incredible food preparation system from France, like having a professional chef right at your side. And the new 22-volume World Book Encyclopedia, including research guide and index volume. World Book is easy to use, easy to read, and easy to understand. And a hot lather machine and a supply of new flavor formula, Search. If you took a Search now, your breath would still be fresh in half an hour. Search keeps on working even after 30 minutes. And a windbreaker and a supply of Armor All Protector. Protects and rejuvenates anything, rubber, vinyl, plastic, leather, and wood. Armor All makes your world less rotten. Party continues now with the star of our show, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you very much, Johnny O. Here we go. Jim, you know what you have to do?
Got to get some match.
Yes. You have to match two to tie. Three to win.
Right.
You ready for that?
Ready.
All right.
Smiling Jim Smith.
From her plantation, Scarlett O'Hara said, "The South will rise again. This year, I have a really modern crop. It's 50% cotton and 50% blank."
Modern crop.
Right. That's why the South will rise again.
I really have a pretty modern crop. 50% cotton.
I got it. Now that it's almost over, I'm
getting... You're finally getting the hang of it. Going downhill a little bit, don't worry. Hang on there, honey. Infusion.
Happy birthday.
Hello there, Jim. Are you ready?
I think.
Charles, you ready? From plantation, Scarlett Harris said, "The South will rise again. This year I have a really modern crop. It's 50% cotton and 50% blank."
50% marijuana?
Honey, I think you just blew it. I don't think as modern as they are, I don't think they're going to say marijuana over there. I don't think any of them even heard of marijuana over there.
What is marijuana?
That would make it rise pretty good, though.
Yes, it will.
That will,
Scoey, show us your answer. He said marijuana.
I said polyester.
Polyester. Knew her well. Yes?
I said Lady Esther. I didn't say Lady Esther. It's 50% cotton and 50% polyester.
Polyester?
But grass is not bad either.
Well, it was a modern crop.
Well, that's dumb. I don't understand that.
I am so totally confused, Colonel. I said yeast.
And you pick on my answer?
Yeast. Oh, it's rising. Yeast will rise again.
Is yeast a bush or a tree?
Yeast is a fungus.
I am doing the best I can for now.
Yes, yeast is a fungus.
It's a vitamin B12 thing.
There's a fungus.
You're not supposed to eat on the show, Sharon. How many times are you going to tell you that? I don't allow eating on my show.
Somebody took my gum from day before yesterday.
You
had it right here.
Would you show us your answer? What does that say? Dacron. Okay.
Dacron.
Dacron.
Well, you don't have
now,
to
Now, here's the way it is, Jim. With that spiffy answer of yours, you got to match the two remaining ones to stay in the game and achieve a tie. The South will rise again. I have a really modern crop, said Scarlett O'Hara. It's 50% cotton and 50%
yeast.
So that means Kathy wins the game. What do you have, Kathy?
Stand
right there, would you?
Sorry, Jim. Too little and too late.
Mary Wicks had marijuana. There you go.
Okay. Well, Jim and I are going out.
Jim is leaving here with $1,200. Congratulations to Jim Smaydack. There he goes. Now, Kathy, there's our new big star wheel. With the aid of this wheel, you can win as much as $10,000 on one single match. But to begin with, we're going to do the audience match, and here we go. We polled a bunch of people in this very room, nice, smart, bright, intelligent, witty people like these, and we said, write down the best answer you can think of to this, freak blank. $500 for matching the most popular, for the second most popular answer, $250, and then for matching the third most frequently given response, $100. Whom do you call on?
Richard.
Freak show.
Yeah! Brett. What Charles is, a freak of nature.
What happens every time Brett drives down her driveway? a freak accident.
A freak accident, freak of nature, and freak show are the three. You can choose one of those or give us one of your own.
Okay, I'll go with freak accident.
Freak accident it is. Charles answer. Let's see it's up there. We'll begin at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Freak show is one that was given to you. Let's see if we get a freak accident out of the next one. Accident it is. Congratulations. You got $250. Okay.
Freak of nature, bad
Let's see what's up on top there.
Freak out.
Freak out. Go, Ori. Freak out it is.
Well, we didn't
say. All right, now we're going to stop right here, Kathy, before we go any further and do a little business with America. Here we go.
When you were a kid,
1-800-497-9776, 1-800-497-9776.
Next time, watch for these bodies.
McLean Stevenson, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Dee Dee Carr, Richard Dawson, and Betty White.
Thank you. Thank you, Sharon. You were wonderful. Thank you all, Richard, Scully. Join us next time in Match Game 78. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 78, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited for broadcast.